Good morning to you, Carl. Okay, let's see who's going to blink first. It was me. It was awkward. You're doing very well to hold it that long. That's even longer than Tony Abbott. Don't.
Oh, she got me.
It's the Melon Festival. I'll show you what they're going to do here. Tommy Stefanovic here, another one of the Stefanovics, is usually behind the camera as part of the camera crew, but you're going to take over for me?
Yeah, mate.
You want to put that on first? Put the helmet on. Yeah, this is the way they do things. We could have taken the watermelon out of it first. Here, you do that. So if things go pear-shaped tonight, or now, then Tommy's going to be reporting from the telethon tonight. Tom Stefanovic making his debut.
Now, unbeknownst to Benny, this is the first time anyone has ever been towed by a motorcycle. Good luck, Benny.
I only want to be with you.
Oh, don't you love Tina Turner? A beautiful performance from her at last night's flood relief telethon. And as you can see, the audience absolutely absorbed.
I love Nutbush City Limits, one of my favourites. You did say Tina Turner. Tina Arena.
Tina Arena. Oh, I was just caught up in that moment, Cam.
I know, it was.
And
one
I completely
of them.
Ruined it.
This is Victoria Azarenka, and this is. Would this put you off? Have a listen. Would this put you off if you were up against this?
Depends where you're up against it.
It sounded like. I'm just going to leave and I'll leave you to it, mate.
All right.
Do we look like a happy family at the moment? Isn't that beautiful? Is Angus the best behaved child on the face of the planet?
Well, this is why he's still sitting here.
That's right.
The moment he starts crying, he's going back to mum. I'll tell you what, this child has a beautiful head of hair, doesn't he? Look at this, magnificent.
It does.
Now it's time for entertainment with Richard.
is he one of mine? What's his name again?
It's Angus.
Yeah, I don't think I got one of them. It's kind of familiar, though, I've got to say.
This season, it's going to be all about camels, reds, bold prints, leopard, zebra, and leather and lace. And shortly, I'll be letting you know what's in for the women.
Stevie Jacobs.
I'm you glad make to hear that laugh. Camels are in.
That, isn't it? No, it's all good. Eh?
Glad to hear that camels are
yeah,
in.
Yeah, an extra hump every now and then is good, isn't
that's
it?
That's right, exactly. Thank you, Stevie.
There's a former mayor in the US who, despite passing away more than 50 years ago, is still causing controversy. Harry Balls won't have a new government centre named after him in Indiana because the city leaders fear they could become the butt of jokes. The current deputy mayor says while they realise Harry Balls was a respected mayor, not everyone outside of Fort Wayne will know that. And in the end, Balls had to be scratched.
Over to you, Carl.
He's done some crosses in his time, but that is without a doubt numero uno. Bunga Bunga Party. Tell me more, Pedro. Get to the bottom of that one.
Do you
one.
Know what a Bunga Bunga Party is, Carlos?
Talk to me, bro.
Well, there's a few meanings. One is that it's a
don't worry about
a
it,
naked
bro.
Party involving a lot of activity. The second, it's a Gaddafi term as well, maybe.
Get yourself to the Vatican. The front door is open, and so I grab this long stabby thing that I have next to the bed just in case someone breaks in.
A long stabby?
Yeah, because your bloke's got to protect his family, right?
Yeah.
So it got me thinking, what do you have by your bed that is long and stabby or whatever that is going to make a mess of someone who tries to break into your house and try and steal something from your home?
I've got a swordy thing. It's got its own case, and inside the wardrobe I've got a steel bat.
A steel bat? What, the one Dennis Lilly used?
A steel baseball bat.
Oh,
it's just
right.
Hidden in the corner.
I'm going to mess with Wilkinson.
Free access.
Georgie, right, do you have something?
Well, Tim's my long stabby thing. But I used to have the Olympic torch under the bed when I was single. But yeah, now I've got Tim.
That's an excellent long stabby thing. Multitude of uses.
Exactly.
Well
thanks,
done.
Lise. You're hearing me.
Yeah, totally. Yeah. My husband's
strong.
My husband's useless.
Is he?
Completely. He sleeps through any strange disturbances.
I need scripts. I think it's news time.
That's too funny. It is. Benny, do you have anything?
Could your eyes water any more than they are right now? No.
No, that is probably one of the funniest things I've ever heard on TV.
Look, I've got just the golf club, so I've got one on each. I've got three stories. Can I make a point? If you've got an intruder coming into your house, why would you want to actually stab them? That means you've got to get up close and personal with them. I'd want to be standing back and whacking them off from a distance.
Yeah. So you don't have
it. It's one of those things you can't not look at, a buttock. It's a man secret that's now out there.
No.
You can't not look at a woman's buttock.
Yes, you could if you tried really,
you can't
really,
do it. It's
really
like,
hard.
It's part of our natural makeup.
Right, okay. So that would be going against the natural order of things.
Well, it's programmed.
Right.
It's like asking your computer to do something it's not programmed to do.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
All right.
Don't think we're not looking at yours.
Oh, exactly, Georgia. Oh, look at that. I've just dropped my pen. Today.
Where is the Muffin Man? You could win $1,000 if you know where the Muffin Man is this morning. And the final clue this morning, the Muffin Man loves his
so many lines.
Don't use one of them.
And in this city, if you love sport, then you love the King.
That was interesting vision, wasn't it?
That was very tempting for you.
Time now for today's Great Gash. Great Cash giveaway. You really enjoyed the last Airbender.
Did you?
Which does sound a lot like a Bucks party in the sky. Ooh, it wasn't just the ladies turning heads yesterday in a case of life imitating art. Our very own Richard Wilkins resembled a certain animal. See if you can pick it.
Alan! 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 Alan!
Alan! Alan! Alan! Alan! Alan! Alan!
After all that, he got dissed. Quick look at the weather now. More showers.
It's going to be 31, Lisa.
Oh, no.
And 32.
Partly cloudy. 27 degrees in Sydney. A sunny day in Canberra. 25 showers in Melbourne and Hobart.
5 in Adelaide and the heat wave continues in Perth. Sun in 34.
From the past, and thanks to one of our viewers, Emma O'Reilly, who sent us these classic pictures from old fashioned catalogues, including this flame resistant matching family sleepwear.
Yeah.
Jumpsuits for men. I'll bring that
look
on.
At the separation there.
Isn't that excellent? They've got hoods, of course. And underneath that jumpsuit, mesh knit underwear. And of course, the ever fashionable men in belted sweaters. Oh, particularly with that hat. It was a good combo.
Stubbies, you know? Stubbies used to keep that.
Yes.
Remember when your dad... Oh, takes
oh
me back.
No, I don't want to think about that.
Dad. How comfortable are stubbies?
Month.
Great all-round shoe.
Fantastic.
And an Australian icon. You know, you can wear them mowing the lawn.
Yeah.
You can wear them watching...
Great save.